In this video, I'm going to show you how to make an exit pop-up using Thrive Architect and Lightboxes. It's very simple to do, and I'm going to show you step-by-step how to do it, so stick around. So what is an exit pop-up? Well, an exit pop-up is a lightbox that usually appears anytime the website visitor engages in an action that can be interpreted as them leaving the page, okay? And usually, this pop-up will appear, and it's an attempt, a last-ditch attempt, to capture that person's email address. And sometimes people give away discount coupons or a free PDF download. It's totally up to you how you want to utilize this. I'm going to leave that up to your imagination. I'm just going to show you how you can get started putting this together. So first of all, if we are in our WordPress dashboard, once you logged in, all you're going to do is you're going to go to pages. You're either going to select a page that you've already built, or you can create one from scratch. Okay. In this case, I'm going to utilize a page that I've already built. Okay. This landing page right here. And if you are interested in learning how to build a landing page using Thrive Architect, right above is a card that's going to appear. And it's a video that I created on how to create a landing page using Thrive Architect. It's a step-by-step tutorial. Go ahead and watch that. Come back and watch this video after, and that way you have a full understanding of how to do this, okay? So first of all, in order to get started, you're going to go over here to the right side and you're going to click on the gear icon, which is the settings icon. Once that opens, you're going to go to page events. And then from here, you're going to select a trigger. So because we are doing an exit pop-up, we're going to select exit intent, okay? So you're going to click on that and you're going to be presented with another option here, okay? It says exit intent settings. Perform this action on mobile devices. If you were to click on this, there's going to be a message that says it's not possible to detect exit intent on a mobile device. So instead, the selected action will be performed after a time delay. So what you can do is you can have this exit pop-up appear after a certain amount of time that your visitor is being has spent on your landing page, okay? So in this case, the default is 10 seconds. So you can leave it at that if you want, or you don't even have to have it at all. But in this case, we're just gonna leave it at the default 10 seconds, okay? And we're gonna click on continue. So you're gonna see in step two that I'm presented with a couple of options, okay? And the reason why I'm presented with a couple of options is that I am a subscriber to Thrive Architect, okay? And by being a subscriber, I have access to all their plugins, and I've installed a plugin called Thrive Leads. If you're new to Thrive Architect, this is the only option you're going to see right here, okay? So for this example, we're going to click on this to open Thrive Lightbox. So now we're going to start building our lightbox. As you can see right here, I've already have some built already, but I'm going to create a brand new one from scratch so you can see how this works, because you're probably not going to have anything in here when you start building your lightbox, okay? So we're just going to create a new lightbox, and we're going to give it a name. So let's call it new exit pop-up, okay? And we're going to save it, okay? And as you can see right here, this is our new lightbox right here. And right down here, you see an option for lightbox animation. There are different options here that you can have this lightbox appear, okay? The default is instant, meaning that if someone is ready to leave, it's just gonna appear, okay? There's also zoom, zoom out, rotational, slide in from the top, slide in from the bottom, and lateral, okay? For this example, I'm going to use instant, but it's up to you which one you want to use, okay? So we're gonna select instant and we're gonna click on save. Now you can see that it's already here, our exit intent. And we're going to edit this lightbox, okay? So we're going to click on that. It's going to open up a brand new window, okay? And when this window opens up, we're going to start crafting our lightbox, okay? So as you can see here, this is what it looks like. And from here, now you can go ahead and start building this, okay? So for instance, what we're going to want to do probably is add in some text, okay? So I'm going to drop in some text right here. And this is where, let's say, I would like to add in my title. So I'm going to add in my headline here. So I'm going to create this headline that says, wait, leaving so soon? Okay, and when I highlight this As with Thrive, you can edit anything you want. Okay, I'm just going to change around the font here. I'm going to choose Lato, which is one of my favorite fonts. Okay, so we're going to select that. We're going to apply it. And then I'm going to center this. Okay, and I'm going to increase the font size here. Okay, we're going to make it a little bit bigger like this. We're going to bold it. Now, of course, this being Thrive, you can edit anything you want. You can change the padding, you know, left, right, whatever you want. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead. I'm just going to leave it at the defaults here. Okay, just so you can see as I build this. So now that I have my headline, let's say I want to add in a picture. Okay, so we're going to go in here and we're going to add in an image. So we're going to drag this in here. I'm going to drop that in and we're going to select an image from our library. So I'm going to utilize this image right here. Okay, I'm going to add that in there. And insert that in there. So wait, leaving so soon. And from here again, you can change the size of your image there. And then I want to just center this here. So I want to change the position. We're going to center this. All right. And we're going to leave that there. Okay. So I have this look of shock, but I'll just move this up here. Okay. Drag that up. That looks good. And then now we want to add in a lead capture form. Okay, so we're gonna go into our elements and we're gonna look for lead generation. So we're gonna drop this in right below. Okay, and then from here you're gonna be able to choose the type of form you want to use. So in this case, I think I'm just going to use this one right here. It's very simple. Drop that in there. Okay, and then from here you're able to customize this form as well. So click on the form right here and you go into the main options. You can edit the form elements, but first of all, before we do that, we're going to just add a connection. Okay. So go ahead. If you've already added your API to your Thrive dashboard, then that's fine. When you click on it, you'll see you have various options for the APIs that you've connected. So in this case, I'm going to connect my active campaign account. And then I'm going to just click on the list here. It's a master contact list. I'm going to leave it at that and I want to click on apply. Okay. So now anytime anybody enters in their email address and click submit, it is going to land in my active campaign email list. Okay. One other thing that you're going to want to do anytime you have these opt-in forms is you're going to want to add in a GDPR checkbox. Okay. So all you do is you click on add new. You're going to find the GDPR checkbox. You can click on that and you're going to click on apply. And what this does is this basically allows a person to click on this box and consent for you to communicate with them. Okay. So you have to have one of these. So you can go ahead and you can add that in there as well. And then when you're done, all you have to do is click on save your work. Okay. So now that has been saved, let's go ahead and take a look at what this looks like. Okay. So we're going to go and let's just save our landing page here again. And once that's saved, let's go ahead and preview this page and test this out. Okay. So here's our landing page and I'm on here and I'm going to pretend like I'm leaving the page. Okay. So I'm going to exit out and you can see that the lightbox appears right away. Okay. And this is where they can type in their email address here, click on the box and click on submit. So there you have it. How to make an exit pop-up using Thrive Architect and Lightboxes. Let me know what you think by dropping your comment down below. Also, if you found this video to be useful, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. I would greatly appreciate it. Lastly, if you're looking to get started with Thrive Architect, then click on the link below to sign up for your account today. This is Ken Furukawa from kenfurukawa.com, and I'll see you in my next video tutorial.